Greetings from Team Rover X. We're a group of passionate undergraduate students from the Vellore Institute of Technology building Mars Rover prototypes. Our team is divided into six departments, namely Electrical, Mechanical, CS and Autonomous, Astrobiology and Life Sciences, Management and R&D. We're related to present our system acceptance review for this year's rover, Kronos.
The Mechanical department focuses on designing, manufacturing and assembling core subsystems of the rover. The drive system of the rover is a double rocker suspension coupled to a modular space frame chassis consisting of V-slot links and aluminium tubes with the aim to improve accessibility and reduce weight. The rover is capable of traversing a wide range of terrain topographies such as rocky, sandy, muddy terrain with steep drops and harsh climbs. The ground clearance has been increased to ensure the rover doesn't collide with obstacles during traversal. The double rocker system coupled with a bar differential helps to maintain the center of gravity and achieve mobility. This configuration maintains proper weight distribution and ensures sufficient ground contact at all times. A kill switch on board the rover instantly stops all the motions of the rover, ensuring safety. For better precision and control during task, a completely new arm with 6 degrees of freedom has been designed and manufactured. Custom manufactured worm gears at all joints increase stability, providing zero backlash with high reduction ratio. Each joint includes a motor with a high resolution encoder for accurate velocity and position control. The end effector uses a worm gear to drive the fingers that are designed to carry out several tasks such as typing on a keyboard with a solenoid added to enable quick and accurate actuation of keys, toggling switches, plugging a USB stick and picking up loads up to 10 kg with a key installed to fasten screws.
Our computer science team works on the core aspects of rover's computation, communication and control. For communication between the base station and the rover, we use a combination of a sector and omnidirectional antenna which has non-line of sight range of 2 km. Manipulation of the custom robotic arm, manual navigation of the rover and controlling the science subsystem is achieved by a combination of 2 gamepads. We retained our reliable core system and continue working on the autonomous system, battery feedback and control system. We are focusing on each node separately to guarantee the repeatability of each function. As of now, we have completed the following milestones: creating waypoint and following GPS goal while avoiding the obstacles smoothly. A square spiral search pattern is used to find and locate Aruko tags and rover follow it transform to autonomously traverse to it. Successful arrival on a post or gate is marked by green flashing LED. We will continue building the recovery behavior, refining our autonomous navigation and optimizing the software after the SAR.
The electrical department works towards the power electronics, drives and control electronics of the rover. Power to the rover is provided by two 24-volt lithium polymer batteries with a total runtime of about 90 minutes. Power from the batteries is distributed through a custom power distribution board, and a kill switch in combination with the relay is used to kill power in case of emergencies. Low-level processing, motor control loops and their associated feedback is handled by an STM32F4 microcontroller with code written in an embedded C in a task-oriented manner. A debug port on the rover uses ST suite of monitoring software to debug the rover in real time.
The science department primarily aims to develop and implement suitable onboard experiments to determine the presence of extinct or no life.
We use an auger and screw conveyor system to collect and distribute soil samples into a wet chemistry lab with caches and analyzes sample with minimal cross-contamination. Our reagent-based analysis consists of carefully optimized qualitative tests which detects the presence of important biosignatures in the soil. We focus on essential inorganic and organic molecules which indicate the presence of extinct or extinct life by showing positive results in some form of visual indication.
A custom-made Raman spectrometer is used to perform the accurate compositional analysis of a given rock sample. An NPK probe is used to analyze the soil sample for presence of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, which is used to determine the organic content, soil quality and its capability to harbor life. It also provides us with the soil pH, moisture and temperature. A digital microscope is used to determine the physical properties of a given sample and aids in the detection of microfossils and microorganisms that might be present. The weather monitoring station on board the rover is equipped with a suite of sensors that measures the atmospheric composition of various gases of biological significance along with temperature, pressure, humidity, and UV radiation.
The research and development department focuses on the long-term goals for the various subsystems of the rover. This year, we are developing a custom CAN node for the robotic manipulator to ease the assembly and cabling of various electronics and to introduce modularity in our systems. For our future rovers, we are designing 3D printed wheels from TPU95A material with a honeycomb structural lattice optimized for shock absorbance and reduction of weight. We are actively working on the unit-based approach for noise removal and building the dataset for various rocks to optimize the inference of a spectra obtained from the Raman spectrometer.
Apart from working towards rover development, the team also believes in inspiring young minds towards space robotics through participating in technological events and conferences. Despite facing pandemic-related setbacks last year and missing out on URC, we have spent the past year preparing for this year's competition. Having gained valuable on-field experience during this year's International Rover Challenge, the team is now working on optimizing and testing the rover for the upcoming URC 2023.